Namaskar and good morning everybody. Today we are going to learn about an important aspect of bacterial physiology as well as metabolism, that is generation or modes of generation of ATP in bacteria. As you know that every cell requires energy for the purpose of basic life activities which the cells carry out. And if we look at the metabolic machinery of every microbial cell, then cells themselves are functioning just like small machines. And these reactions which are going on inside the cell, they are always as per the reactions that take place in chemistry. You have learned lot of reactions in chemistry also, and you must be knowing that chemical reactions, they follow laws of thermodynamics. Likewise, reactions which take place inside the bacterial cell, which we call metabolic reactions, they also follow laws of thermodynamics. And the basic understanding of this thermodynamics helps us to understand these reactions in a much better way. Metabolic reactions can be broadly classified as catabolic reactions as well as anabolic reactions. The reactions which are degradative reactions, during which complex macromolecules are broken down into simple substances, are known as catabolic reactions, and they are generally energy generating reactions, whereas anabolic reactions are those reactions which utilize this particular energy and which are associated with biosynthesis of building blocks as well as macromolecules. In general, we can say that the reactions which are taking place inside the cell, they are based upon production, conservation as well as utilization of energy. And such kind of energy changes which occur during biochemical reactions, during metabolic reactions, it is broadly known as study of bioenergetics. And as I earlier mentioned, bioenergetics or the reactions that we are going to study as a part of bioenergetics, they always follow, they always obey laws of thermodynamics. You all have studied that energy is the basic requirement of every living cell. And living cells carry out various activities by using this energy. The activities may include chemical work, or it may include transport work, or it may include mechanical work. And large amount of energy likewise is also required for the purpose of biosynthesis. From where does the energy is generated within a cell? The sources of energy for a bacterial cell, for a microbial cell, could be a chemical compound, and those microorganisms which derive energy from chemical substrates by using chemicals as oxidizable substrates, they are broadly known as chemotrophs, and those which derive their energy from sunlight, they are broadly known as phototrophs. As you can see from this slide, it is the basis of chemotrophy as well as phototrophy. You can see that the chemical compounds which can be utilized can be organic compounds or they can be inorganic compounds, and accordingly we may classify the bacteria as chemoorganotroph or chemolithotroph. Whereas in case of phototrophs, you can see that source of energy is the radiant energy, and the organisms have a capacity, they have inherent capacity to harvest radiant energy because they have green pigment chlorophyll, and these are known as phototrophs. From this table, you can see a detailed nutritional classification: photoautotrophs, photoheterotrophs, chemoautotrophs as well as chemoheterotrophs, along with the name of the substrates which they use, as well as along with the name of electron donors which they use during the process of energy generation. I have also tried to give you a summary of the nutritional categories among bacteria. Depending upon the mode of nutrition, you may classify broadly bacteria as autotroph as well as heterotrophs. And among both, autotroph could be a photoautotroph or it could be a chemoautotroph, and among heterotroph also you may be a photoheterotroph or chemoheterotroph, because you know when we are talking about the energy generation, we also must have an idea about the kind of substrates, kind of sources the organisms are going to use as source of energy, and those substrates will decide the nutritional category of that particular group. If we talk about the flow of energy as well as carbon in ecosystem, then for us, for every one of us, sun is the ultimate source of energy. The earth on which we live can be considered as an open source of energy, and the radiant energy, it is harvested by green plants as well as algae, and then we all, algae, we all, humans, animals as well as other microorganisms, they are largely dependent upon this harvested form of energy that we obtain from the green plants. In what form cell traps and utilizes the energy? When we talk about energy generation in bacteria, let me emphasize that microorganisms are believed to be highly efficient in conservation of energy. Whatever energy is generated during reactions, during biochemical reactions, that energy is hardly wasted. It is immediately converted into form of a high energy chemical bond like ester bond, phosphoester bond or thioester bond, and those compounds which are having one or more number of high energy bonds, they are known as high energy compounds or high energy intermediates. You can see from the diagram various kinds of energy rich compounds, that is 1,3-biphosphoglyceric acid, ATP. As you all know, that ATP is regarded to be the universal source of energy for microorganisms. But apart from that, you may have acyl coenzyme A derivatives like acetyl coenzyme A, compounds like phosphoenol pyruvate. They all have one or more number of high energy bond in the form of phosphoanhydride bond, and by hydrolysis of this bond, required amount of energy can be generated as and when required. You can see the structure. The most common source of energy, as I mentioned earlier, is the ATP, which works not only as a source of energy during reactions, but it also works as a phosphate group donor. You can see the structure of ATP, and you can also see the high energy bond of ATP. Again, here also you can see two phosphoanhydride bonds in the structure of ATP, and in the model also you can see that how these phosphoanhydride bonds are highlighted. These are some of the examples of other energy rich compounds apart from ATP, that is GTP, UTP or CTP or DATP. ATP can be used as a general source of energy, whereas UTP is used for biosynthesis of polysaccharides. GTP, it is very well used for biosynthesis of proteins as well as porphyrins, and likewise CTP also, it is used for biosynthesis of lipids as well as phospholipids. At the same time, from the table you can also have a broad idea about the standard free energy change, that is value of delta G whenever such high energy intermediates are hydrolyzed. You can see that the values of most of these compounds, they are in the minus. That means whenever such high energy compounds are hydrolyzed, it is always that little amount of energy is released, and that's why this energy which is released can be used up by cell for biosynthetic activities. Again, you can see example of some of the standard free energy change for some of the chemical reactions like hydrolysis of ATP to ADP. You can see that when ATP is hydrolyzed to ADP, minus 7.3 kilocalories of energy is released, that is value of delta G0 is minus 7.3 kilocalories. Similarly, compounds like glutamine or ethyl acetate, they are also, when they are hydrolyzed and whenever high energy bond is broken, you have minus value of delta G0. Let us now focus onto the various biochemical mechanisms for generation of ATP in bacteria. It can be divided as substrate level phosphorylation. Then there are special mechanisms which madam is going to talk about, that is use of electron transport chain, where she will also talk to you about energy which is derived by a respiratory mechanism, namely aerobic respiration as well as anaerobic respiration, which is an important energy generation mechanism in chemotrophs. And finally, if we look at phototrophs, then in case of phototrophs, energy is principally generated by a process which is known as photophosphorylation. Just we recall earlier things which I told you, that whenever, you know, value of delta G is negative, then the reaction is always exothermic or exergonic reaction. It always proceeds spontaneously because it is an energy generating reaction. Whereas if you learn about, or if you go to biosynthetic reactions which requires an input of energy, there the value of delta G0 is always positive and the reactions never proceed spontaneously. They are said to be endothermic reaction. And if I just give you an analog, mitro, chemistry ni andar tame aaj prakriyaone ushma shoshak અને ઉષ્મા ક્ષેપક પ્રક્રિયાઓ તરીકે ઓળખો છો, જેને આપણે માઇક્રોબાયોલોજીની અંદર એક્ઝોથર્મિક અને એન્ડોથર્મિક પ્રક્રિયાઓ તરીકે ક્લાસિફાય કરીએ છીએ. એ વેરી સિમ્પલ મિકેનિઝમ યુઝડ બાય મેની કેમોટ્રોપ્સ, ઇટ ઇઝ ધ સબસ્ટ્રેટ લેવલ ફોસ્ફોરિલેશન. બેઝિકલી જનરેશન ઓફ એટીપી, ઇટ ઇઝ ફોસ્ફોરિલેશન ઓફ એડીપી. બટ દેટ ઇનઓર્ગેનિક ફોસ્ફેટ વિચ ઇઝ એડેડ ટુ એટીપી, ઇટ ઇઝ એડેડ અલોંગ વિથ ધ ફોર્મેશન ઓફ ફોસ્ફોએનહાઇડ્રાઇડ બોન્ડ. And because it is formation of phosphoanhydride bond, it requires an input of energy. There are microorganisms which are able to carry out phosphorylation of ADP by direct interaction of ADP with a high energy intermediate such as phosphoenol pyruvate or 1,3-biphosphoglyceric acid. Recall, in the earlier slide I have shown you that both phosphoenol pyruvate as well as 1,3-biphosphoglyceric acid are high energy intermediates. They have a phosphoanhydride bond. During the reaction between such high energy intermediate like phosphoenol pyruvate and ADP, the phosphoanhydride bond of phosphoenol pyruvate is broken and that phosphate is added to ADP along with formation of a new phosphoanhydride bond, leading to formation of ATP. And this is how ADP gets phosphorylated, by its direct interaction with a high energy intermediate, and the mechanism is known as substrate level phosphorylation. Generally, substrate level phosphorylation, it is the widespread mechanism of ATP generation in chemoheterotrophs, especially anaerobic chemoheterotrophs which are having fermentative metabolism, which do not have components of electron transport chain, and which are not able to use inorganic compound like oxygen or another inorganic compound as final electron acceptor. And those bacteria which are having fermentative mode of metabolism, during their fermentative reaction, they generate ATP by substrate level phosphorylation. Now, having learned about substrate level phosphorylation, we are now going over to another mechanism. We have learned about the basic aspects of energy as well as energy generation. Now, a very important mechanism of ATP generation by respiratory mechanism, it is going to be discussed by my distinguished colleague, Professor Nilaben Upadhyay. She is head of the microbiology department in Gujarat College, and I request her to discuss, to take the discussion further and to give you a very good idea about the respiration as well as role of electron transport chain. Nilaben, please.
Welcome to all of you in this lecture. Today I will discuss about energy derived from chemicals. In that, my colleague Mr. Anand Bhatt has already explained about substrate level phosphorylation. I will be discussing about respiration linked photophosphorylation. In respiration linked photophosphorylation, we have to discuss about aerobic respiration and anaerobic respiration both. Respiration is energy yielding oxidation reduction reaction where organic or inorganic compound serves as electron acceptor, electron donor, and inorganic compound serves as electron acceptor. In aerobic respiration, molecular oxygen serves as final electron acceptor, and in anaerobic respiration, oxidized compound other than molecular oxygen serves as final electron acceptor. Now, these aerobic and anaerobically respiring organisms undergoes electron transport chain, and by operation of electron transport chain, they produce large amount of energy, and respiration or respiratory metabolism yields maximum ATPs. In this particular figure, it is schematic representation of an electron transport chain, where we can see sequential oxidation and reduction of various carriers. Carriers are present in the membrane of bacteria and inner membrane of mitochondria, and they are oriented in a specific manner, and that is how finally terminal electron acceptor is reduced. Now, in this electron transport chain, there are number of carriers, and these carriers in most of the cases are flavoproteins, iron sulfur proteins, quinones and cytochromes. Of course, in different organisms, type of carriers are different, but most commonly found carriers are what I will be discussing just now. First is flavoprotein. Flavoprotein, that is that includes FMN and FAD, flavin mononucleotide and flavin adenine dinucleotide. This is the structure of FMN. FMN and in FAD, active site is same. They are derived from yellow prosthetic group.